Hello, this is Jake from the Corona team, and in the next few minutes, you'll be able to render this interior visual. By the end, you're going to know how to realistically illuminate your scenes, add 3D models and materials before rendering your final image. And make sure you download the scene file in the description if you want to follow along. Open up the scene and you'll find this empty room. To demonstrate how simple Corona is to use, let's add a Corona sun and sky. Head to the toolbar and click on this sun. Click and drag and the sun is created. We can also add a Corona sky over here in the Modify tab. We can now navigate into our interior. Press F3 and we can see what's going on a little bit better. If we hit the camera with the plus button, it's going to create a camera from the view. Now if we click the interactive render button from the toolbar, we can see our preview render in real time. And this means that any changes we make in the viewport are reflected in the render straight away. And we can see this if we add a light to our scene by clicking the light button and clicking and dragging in our scene. This new window that's opened up is called the virtual frame buffer. And other than seeing the rendered image, we can also make adjustments to our images here on the right. So I'm just going to quickly delete this light. And under tone mapping, we can turn our exposure up. We can change our white balance and we can change our highlight compress. And right now our scene's looking a little bit empty. So let's click on the Cosmos button and add some models. Chaos Cosmos gives us access to 3D models, materials, and HDRIs. The models are categorized, searchable, and filterable. To download a model, just click the download button on the model you want to use. And then click and drag, and as simple as that, we have our model in our scene. Now, if you want to follow along, here are the models we're going to use in this scene, but also feel free to browse the Cosmos library and add any models you like the look of. I've added and positioned the models over here, and I've rotated our camera towards the new 3D models. So if we press C on the keyboard, we're going to look through our camera. F3 is going to let us see what's happening in the viewport, and then we can hit interactive render again. Now that we've placed our models, let's take a look at adding and changing some materials. And Corona has made it super simple to add materials. Just open up the material library, which you can find on the Corona toolbar. And let's start with the floor in our room. So select the flooring category on the left and click and drag a material you like the look of onto our floor. And you can see that gets updated. So choose a material you want to use on your floor. If we select our floor and we go to the modifier tab, you'll notice that we have a UVW map set to real world size. And seeing as all Corona's materials are set to real world scale, this makes mapping our textures a breeze. For the walls, we can try another way. And this time let's select the wall and then we'll go to the wall category. And then all we have to do is right click and assign to selected. So again, choose a material you like the look of. And once we're happy with the 3D models and materials in our scene, we can render a final image. And Corona's simplicity is the key to its success. And the main settings are optimized, so there's no need to change anything. When we hit render in the virtual frame buffer, the image is going to continue to render until we're happy with the result and we stop the render in the frame buffer. If we did want to set a time or a noise limit, then we can do so in the render setup. Click here to get to the render settings, and under scene, we can set different progressive render limits. And think of these as targets for when the render will stop. We can also turn on denoising, which will help reduce render time. So just head down to denoising and select Corona High Quality. To learn more about denoising, check out the how-to video. And for the progressive rendering limits, we can put in a time limit. So the render will stop after 10 minutes. Or a noise limit. 6 or 7% is good for draft renders and between 3 and 5% for final images. So let's put 3% in and hit render. And there we go. Feel free to experiment with some tone mapping. And when you're happy, you can click save and save to your desired format. Make sure you share what you create with us using the link in the description and check out our other videos to start exploring what Corona can do for you.